I'm Santosh Gadamkar. Today's problem is about the simple harmonic motion. This is the problem. The motion of a particle is given by x is equal to 2 sine omega 2. The x is given here. x is nothing but 2 sine omega t plus pi by 6. You have to convert into, this is already in radians, so we have to convert into degree, 2 sine omega t plus pi by 6 into 180 divided by pi. You will get 2 sine omega t plus 30 degree. They have given the resultant here, okay, and one more component they have given, it sine omega t plus 5 by 2. That means they have given x1 is nothing but a 1 sine omega t minus pi by 3. This is nothing but sine omega t plus pi by 3 into 180 divided by pi. You will get sine omega t minus 60 degree, where a1 is nothing but what? 1. Here the a1 is nothing but what? 1. That's the important thing we have to consider. Now x is given, resultant is given, and x1 is given. What about the x2? In normal case, we in the problem they have given x1 and x2, we are finding the resultant. Here the resultant given and x2, x1 is given, therefore the x2 will be what? X2 will be a2 sine omega t plus 5. This is similar to that of x is nothing but x1 plus x2. Now substitute the values here in the place of x. Substitute the value 2 sine omega t plus 30 degree plus sine omega t minus 60 degree plus a2 plus a2 sine omega t plus 5. Now apply the formula. We have to apply the formula here. The formula for the formula application is sine a plus b is nothing but what? Sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. One more, sin A minus B formula you have to use here. Sin A cos B minus cos A sin B. This is the formula we have to use in the above equation. Now use that formula, it becomes 2 sine omega t into cos 30 plus 2 cos omega t into sine 30 is equal to sine omega t into cos 60 minus cos omega t into sine 60 plus a2 sin omega t into cos 5 plus a2 cos omega t into sin 5. Make this and this term common, and this common here. It becomes, now this can be written as what? Sin omega t 2 cos 30 plus cos omega t 2 sin 30. Now similarly here, sin omega t cos 60 plus a2 cos 5. Next, plus cos omega t a2 sin phi minus sin 60. Now equating this equation, equating the above equation, it becomes 2 cos 30 cos 60 plus a2 cos 5, 2 cos 30 minus cos 60 is nothing but a2 cos 5, 1.232 is equal to a2 cos 5, equation 1. Next, 2 sin 30 is equal to a2 sin 5 minus sin 60. 2 sin 30 plus sin 60 is equal to a2 sin 5. The value will be 1.8660 a2 sin 5. Equation 2. Squaring and adding equation, squaring and adding equation 192, you will get what? A2 square sin square 5 plus cos square 5, 1.8660 square plus 1.232 whole square. The value for A will be, A2 will be 2.236. Dividing the equation 2 by 1, you will get tan phi, that is 1.866 divided by 1.232. The phi will be 56. Bring the inverse here, it becomes 56.566 degree. Tan inverse, make it the tan inverse here. You will get the answer here, tan inverse. The final resultant x2 is nothing but what? 2.236 sine omega t plus 56.566. That's the answer for the resultant of x2. The simple thing of this problem is that they have given the x resultant and x1. We have to find the x2. Okay, I will go for the graphical method now. Graphical method. I will consider the values here. X is nothing but 2 sine omega t plus 30 degree. Next, x1 is nothing but sine omega t minus 60 degree, where a1 is nothing but 1, and x2 is nothing but what? A2 sine omega t plus 5. I'll consider the scale here. 1 centimeter is nothing but 2 centimeter. Now I will draw the scale. This is the x, this is y. X and y, have drawn it. Resultant, first x, 2, angle 30 degree from the x, 30 degree from this point, 30 degree, 30 degree, 2 is nothing but 4, I have taken the 4 here. Is 4, and this is a2, 30 degree. And next, what next is known as 60 degree, but it is minus, therefore from this point it is 60 degree, because it is a minus sign, 60 degree. What about a1 is nothing but 1 here. A1 is nothing but 1. 1 is nothing but here 2. Because we have taken 1 centimeter is nothing but 2. A1 is nothing but 1. Now, next, move exactly parallel to this one. Move exactly parallel. Next, exactly parallel to this one. Draw the line from this point to this point. Next, draw exactly parallel to this one. This is B, this is C, this is A. If you measure the value, it will be A2 will be 2.25, and if you measure the angle, it will be 57 degree, and the final resultant will be, for the x2 value will be A2 is equal to 2.25 sine omega t plus 57 degree. I am Santosh Gaidankar.